Notice how things change in our diagram. Whereas previously, we were copying all the properties from car.methods over to the new instance objects, now we're simply going to make those new instance objects delegate their failed lookups to car.methods. This is an important shift in that it allows us to skip an expensive step of copying properties over when we build a new object. It's interesting to note that if Netscape hadn't pushed for adding Java-esque keywords and features to the language way back in 1995, we might have been writing code very much like this for all of our JavaScript classes. The steps for making a class in this prototypal pattern are pretty clear. All you need is a function that allows you to make instances, a line in that function that generates the new instance object, a delegation from the new object to some prototype object, and some logic for augmenting the object with properties that make it unique from all the other objects of the same class. Since this pattern is so common, the language designer decided to add official conventions to support it. You see how we're making a methods object here and adding it as a property of the car function object? If we plan to use prototypes for all of our classes, we'll probably be doing this every time. Since building a holder object for methods and attaching it as a property to the constructor function is so common, the language does this for you automatically. Whenever a function is created, it'll have an object attached to it that you can use as a container for methods, just in case you plan on using that function to build instances of a class. The crazy thing is, this occasionally handy property, the one the language is going to build for you, is not stored at the key .method. Although we had chosen to store our handy method container object at the key .methods, the default object that comes with every function is stored at the key .prototype. It's just a naming choice, but it has been a very confusing naming choice throughout the history of the language, and I'll explain why. But first, let's refactor our code to make use of the fact that we're given this free .prototype property where we can store all of our methods. Since I know this object is going to be created for me, and all I really need to do is add a move method, I can take out the object literal. And all I really need to do is define this .move method on an existing .prototype object. But car.methods doesn't exist anymore, so we need to refactor the rest of our code to reflect the use of the provided container object, which is now stored at car.prototype.